Hey there, everybody. It's on fire because my record key is for some reason the same as the grenade key, so, you know, whatever. I'll count my losses. Welcome back to the Rachel Dratch Survival Difficulty Roleplay playthrough of Fallout 4. And we're going to dive right in. Last time we did the first part of the game, and this time we're going to do the second part of the game. So, great. Let's see what's on the plate, what's on the hot plate. So, alright, we just did that thing, so there's, like, this Preston Garvey stuff. We could go to Diamond City. I played this game before, though. I know it's gonna be, like, kinda hard, because I'm level 3 and I don't have any good stats, and it's on survival difficulty. So I'm gonna go talk to Preston Garvey, get some Fed XP, and then continue on my way. Oh, I don't have a lot of health, either. Oh, that's rough. Oh, he's just gonna walk. Okay. In that case, so yeah, Mom said I can only play for 1 hour tonight, so it's gonna be a shorter session, but that's okay. Let's see if I can build stuff yet in the game. All right, I have it. Oh no, okay, cool. See, this is why I picked up all those clipboards earlier. So okay, I realize this is gonna be confusing because when I say I, you don't know if I'm role-playing as Rachel Dratch or if I'm just talking as Caleb. And that's going to be hard, you know. I could do the LARPing thing, which is like when I'm doing this, it means I'm out of character. But instead, I'm just going to make you guess constantly and never know for sure. So I'm going to build a bed because nobody likes to never sleep in their whole life. So, oh, doggy. You're looking good, buddy. Just build a nice little bed. Right. Oh, it has to be perfect. Right there. Out of duct tape and my preserved cigarette pack. That was my prison currency. Kind of devastated about that. But you know what? It's okay. Rachel makes do with what she has. Now she's going to sleep on these cigarettes for 1 hour. You know what? That was my gamer speaking. Rachel's not going to sleep for 1 hour. I mean, she is. She sleeps for 1 hour, wakes up. Sorry, Rachel. You need your good 8 hours on top of that. Living in the apocalypse is rough, you know? Sometimes you got to survive. That is why I'm playing on survival. Because that's what life is for a working comedian in this working world. I'm just going to make sure I'm on survival. Yep. Okay. And, ooh, it's bright outside. Take a... Oh, God, I got a bunch of shit in my nose. Take a deep breath, and let's go meet Preston. I remember when all this stuff wasn't rusty. I used to sit on this thing. I used to sit on that back before the apocalypse happened. Used to walk on this path. There were none of that blood. Oh, jeez. I remember when this nuclear bomb hit and it just ripped up this part of this bridge. Like, that nuclear bomb really got this part of this bridge pretty hard. It was rough. Certain houses, oof, gone for good. 25 miles an hour, okay. Test it. Yeah. Fast. Okay. Preston, this is just a walkthrough. This whole thing is kind of like a walkthrough for if you want to play the game in a really inefficient way. So I'm just going to treat it like a walkthrough. Here's Preston Garvey, you know, great guy.
Hey there.
I'm glad you decided to come with us. I should have listened to
Yeah, look at me when you're
along.
Talking to me, Preston.
Pretty nice place she's found for us. I think we could settle down here. Make it a place to call home. What do you think?
Well, this literally was my home. You doink?
Yeah. I used to like living here. Before the war.
What do you mean? Before what war? Are you saying...
Well, that was not convincing voice acting. Voice actor who plays Preston Garvey. I'm cheeky.
What do you think I'm saying?
Well, that you're from before the war. The Great War.
The Great War. Nice.
Like one of those old ghouls you sometimes run into. Is that true?
In what fiction do they not use the Great War? Ghouls? Well, Preston, if you know I'm from before the war, and I'm not a ghoul, then why would I know what a ghoul is, boo?
Ghouls from before the war?
Yeah, I've run into a few that old. I guess ghouls don't really age. Radiation preserves them or something.
Hmm.
Obviously, you're no ghoul.
The question of the hour
made me wonder.
Is age physical? Or is it time? Would a little ball of zirconium alloy age? Despite being impervious?
Take your time.
To the world around it, you know, I don't know. I think ghouls age. I think a ghoul's still 200, even if he's not dead.
Yeah, 200 years ago. Sort of. I was born over 200 years ago, but I was frozen or
that
something
can't,
for most of it.
Can't be.
Just
can't
woke
be comfy.
Up a little while ago.
Right.
Damn. Like one of those old pre-war
ghouls. Yeah, we've
ghouls.
Been over this, Preston.
You say you were frozen.
Ghouls.
Anybody else make
really
it
hitting
out
that nail on the head, making sure we understand, like, there's ghouls in this game, people. Yeah,
I don't want to talk about it,
Preston.
No worries. We've all got our past to deal with. I don't need to know anything you don't want to tell me. Anyway,
well,
I am
at least he's
here.
Okay with boundaries, right?
And I hope you don't mind, but I've got another favor to ask. I've had word from a settlement asking for help.
Hmm.
There's still hope in there, Minutemen out there. Somewhere. The only chance to start rebuilding the Minuteman is to show people that they can count on us when they need us. Trouble is, I've got my hands full here. Do you think you could go help out with the settlement?
Oh, good. I was hoping for a chance to rescue some more helpless villagers.
It's not that people are helpless. They just need someone to give them a helping hand sometimes.
Oh.
Ding. That's what the Minutemen are supposed to be all about.
Wow,
way,
look at all that juice.
You want to help out around here at all?
Double ding.
Talk to Sturgis.
And I don't even have
sure
the perk
all the help
Idiot Savant. Kind of insensitive. But I don't even have that. I just got two levels. Alright. Talk to the settlers at Ten Pines Bluff. That way. Well, I've slept. Let's see what kind of juice I got here in my INV slot area. Got this heavy minigun. It's not gonna... I'm gonna have to put that away. No ammo for it. Oof. Right, the auto pistol. Now comes the decision. Yeah. So I was discussing this a little bit in the previous video, and I just think that if you're a person without combat experience and you're put into a situation where you need to fight for your life, having an automatic weapon would just be, like, I think more intuitive, and it would feel safer for a lot of people, you know, just to be able to squeeze the trigger, just close your eyes, spray and pray, hold on, just squeeze it like a little hand strengthener, just let the bad guys disappear. That's what I'm going to do. Now, I'm no commando, but I'm taking this perk. Great line. That was a great one-liner. Okay. Kind of want big sale, cap collector. So, like, Rachel Dratch, she's not the top-tier star out there, but she is a Hollywood lady, and any Hollywoodster has mastered the art of the deal. So it would make sense that she was a collector of caps. But I don't really know what caps are yet in the game. Like, I haven't had to buy anything, so I think I'm going to hold off. All I know is that Cold Steel is the language I'm being forced to speak in this horrible world. Oh, right, I still have Wasteland Whisperer. Nice. Okay. Going back out there, baby. Going tab. Is that which button makes that come out? Is this the auto? It's got some good bullets in it. I wonder, should do 12 damage now? Yeah, 12 damage. Woo. Okay. So, since the last time I've played, I have had the pleasure of doing some research. Alright, it's not. So, you can hold down the reload button to put your gun away. I might have said that already, but it's really handy. Just gotta say it again. I didn't know that, like, for most of my first playthrough this game, so it's nice to have a shopping cart, just like where I used to ride in as a kid. This is both roleplay and RL Caleb speaking. I had the pleasure of watching the movie Sisters in theaters, which features Rachel Dratch as the notorious Kelly, the character who, I'm not going to spoil anything, but, you know, she was quite the hoot back in high school, and stuff maybe died down a little bit for her, but really, to whom has it not since high school, right? Am I right? The good old days? Oh, I just remember, chucking that pigskin around with Bobby. Oh, yeah, the good old days. That was when I was the hottest I ever would be. It's just a downhill from here, kids. It's just downhill from here. First time I ever grabbed a cold one with Bobby after chucking the skin around. Now I don't fit in anywhere. Now I just got my mom. Got my old mom taking care of mom. Nah, can't get wasted, because, you know, mom might need me to give her a drive. So, she's not the same anymore. Mom's not picking me up, I'm picking mom up now, from the school. Yeah, back in the day, though, back in the day, we had some parties. I had a party. I drank bleach. Just maybe I didn't. That's a little hardcore. Looks like I just stopped talking because there's this guy. Wow, you look like a genuine hipster.
I could use a hand here if you're all done gawking, you know.
Well, yeah.
I could probably help for a few caps extra.
I was going to give you something anyway. 75 caps for your time?
75 caps for only The more money I come across, the more problems I see. Yeah.
Not sure if I'm up for it.
I just said
more caps
problems.
Might change my mind, though.
Not going to make this easy.
What I meant was problems.
All right. 100 caps, then.
Oh, baby, baby, baby! Even more money! Do I risk it all? In one big, just risk it all.
You want this pump fixed, right? Throw in a few more caps and you've got a deal.
Okay, 125. That's it.
I got it. Mm-hmm. So in a lot of games, red is bad. And that's true in this game. The red things are harder. Forget it. Wow. Wow, I'm not that evil.
Help you with what exactly?
I'm trying to fix this old water.
Gonna take a sippy
here.
There'll
be plenty of scrap in here, if I can get it drained out.
Yeah, you want me to drain scrap out of water, dork?
No, what are you really up to here?
Maybe I got some friends who like.
Jeez, it pays to be a smooth talker in these apocalyptic times.
Guys like you into. Are you gonna help or what?
Yeah, sure.
What do you need help with?
The pump isn't in top shape, but
it pull the blood.
The leaks will be on.
Oh, I just skipped dialogue. I was thinking in this roleplay playthrough, I should never skip any dialogue because, like, roleplaying, etc. But this guy is such a fucking rat on the floor. He's such a hole in the wall. Such a this and that, such and such, that I just don't even give two wags of a tail about his fucking ass. Taboo tattoos? Perfect. Just what I knew this guy was a hipster. We got a light bulb. We got a... Ooh, drugs. This is my first drugs time. Maybe. No, I took some medics earlier. So there's drugs in this game. Yeah, we've been over this. Rachel, etc. Everybody makes their own life choices. I'm really tired. I, like, recently woke up. I've been having a weird sleep schedule, everybody. It's pretty rough. Tell you what. But, ooh, some money. I bet this is, you know, that guy's Wilkins McGruffintuff, but I'm just going to take it. Dirty water. No. Pop that sucker open. Smell it. Smells gross. Don't want any of that. Yeah. I'll try to whittle my way. Oh, but I got one bobby pin.
Huh. Oh.
A master salutster. Yeah. Keep your gun. Master Laku. Lak. Ticker. Ooh. Oh, baby. Sweet spot.
Got it.
Psycho. I am a psycho when I need to be. Guess that's kind of harsh terminology there. I guess what I mean is that I am what popular culture would describe as a psycho when I need to be. What is that beast of glory? What beast is this? I would not kill a beast. It looks like there's a little guy riding. Oh, it's an angry. Oh, stay away from me. Dog, no, dog. Ah. Oh, baby. Oh, shit. No, God. Dang it. Baby. Oh. What have I got? Oh, I can't just let it bleed out. I have to use the meat. I have to use every piece of the meat. I'm getting chased. I gotta use. Oh, all of it. I'm just gonna. Jeez, forgive me. Oh, jeez, a dog. Oh, a dog. I guess I'll just scoop the meat out of its dead body. Yes, use all pieces. Oh, my gosh. Oh, another one. Yeah, walk away when I'm pointing my gun at you, you doggy. Oh, gosh. It just exploded. Where's its exploded body? There we go, okay. So anyway, on to that place I was going, that direction. Yeah, so I saw Sisters. You know, I liked it. I thought it did what I preferred. Oh, I just got this runny nose today. It's rough. Waking up at a weird time, tired, got a runny nose, playing some Fallout. One of these things is not like the other. Ha ha ha, am I right? Shameless plug. Which is what I wish I had for my nose. So Sisters, there's a dog. Dogs are bad. I've learned that dogs are bad. So I'm just gonna shoot them to death. Yeah, it had a slow start, right? Like, not a slow start, but just like a bad start. Like the movie was bad at the beginning. And then it got better. Which is, like, really good, right? It's just so much better than a movie starting good and then getting bad, right? At least in my IMO. Yo, we're gonna... Oh, no, it's the cranker. Oh, Alpha. Jeez, this dog is juiced. I've said juice, like, 30 times. Yeah, like, there's that guy in it who's, like, a no-name next to these, like, two riveting, star-studded actresses, plus Rachel Dratch, who is also a riveting star-studded actress, but she's not one of the, like, flagship front-runners of the movie. So, yeah. But... Yeah, that guy, he just kind of stuck out as being, like, kind of out of place. You know, like, why wasn't it, like, some comedy guy, right? Wah-ha-ha-ha! And, like, John Cena. I feel like John Cena, he was in Trainwreck. Like, he's just getting into movies because, f- for some reason he's becoming culturally relevant again. Like, does anybody understand why John Cena's, like, big again? I don't know. I mean, he's always been big. Right? Like, he's a monster. But, I don't know. Memes, I guess. You know, fucking memes. What does this gentleman have to want to do? Whoa! What is this?
What do you want?
What does this guy
want?
We don't
need any more trouble around here.
Yeah, look me in the eyes.
If I told you I'm with the Minutemen, would you still want to shoot me?
You're with the Minutemen? I didn't really think you fellas still existed. We sent word with one of them passing traitors.
Fellas.
Honestly, I never expected anything to come of it.
Antiquated.
Most people don't put much stock in the Minutemen these days. After Quincy.
Put much
bad
stock?
Business, that.
Who wrote this guy's words? Fellas and stock? What the fuck? Yeah.
Do you want my help, or should I be on my
Somebody's like, this is my big break. Idea. I'm going to write this character, and then they're going to notice me, and then I'll get the Fallout 5 lead writing position. I'm so sorry to all the people who did that, who are watching this, and they just feel bad about doing that. And I just brought it to light, and I ruined your career. Wow. Yeah, I don't want you to join.
I'll take
care
of them.
Just let me do this.
Thanks, friend. If you folks are for real this time.
Thanks, friend. Yeah, you think we're friends all of a sudden? You're sticking your two barrels right up in my jawbones, you doink. All right. Ooh, it's some kind of primitive wind device. And a skittering flap. Ooh, flappies. What? It's like I'm in Nausicaa of the Valley of the Wind. Or is it just the Valley of Wind? What's this quest? Is this Corvega Assembly Plant? Oh, please, no. Well, Corvega Assembly Plant is, in my opinion, and the opinion of several other people, kind of, like, too hard for being where it is in the game. But you know what else is too hard? Rachel fucking Dratch. So I'm gonna go do this shit. Something comforting about following the train tracks. You used to have a friend who would lay pennies down on the train tracks and then stand real close to the train they passed, and one day the penny shot off, and she got scared because it shot off, and then from that day forth she stood farther away. Tell that to your mom. Alright, what kind of business? So I know I said I was just gonna squeeze, but like... Yay! But I am taking it easy. Yip, yip, yip! Oh my gosh, that one just jacked the Christ out of me. Holy moly. From the Jungle Books franchise. Oh, just get in the fight, bathing fire! Hellfire! In this situation, I feel uncomfortable as a comedian. Okay. Aid me, world. Aid Stimpak. Oh, aid me. Okay, running. And I turn around. What do I see? Three little ghoulies approaching me. That one's one down to the market. He said, "Who goes to the market?" And I said, "Shh, trust." And I said, "Shh, baby. Hush, little ghoulie." Oh, if only I hadn't thrown that my only other grenade at myself at the beginning of this video. And I had one. Had one more. I wish that I had one. I died. You know what they say, though. Oh, this Corvega Assembly Plant mission, am I right? Oh, haven't even got there, but ooh-wee. Hard mission. Jesus. What do I have? Oh, my shotgun. Oh, my shotgun. I'm gonna use the doozy out of this guy. Alright. Gonna stick that there. And I wonder what's in here? My baseball bat? So we got this. We got a little bit of this. Okay. Oh. I don't even remember what the heck I was talking about. Yeah, we got the sneak attack. Look at all that damage. Now that is what I call massive amounts of damage. Absolutely. Oh, the drive-by. Dog action. Okay. Yeah, I think maybe my strategy is just like my dog does everything. What? My dog is a professional wrestler. Okay. Who else wants to play with doggy? Right? Am I right, ladies and gentlemen? Seek and destroy, pup. Seek and destroy. Take some of that good, yummy meat. Okay. Bedford Station. Oh, yeah, I took the... Took the kids here. Took the husband. I call them the kids. Husband and the baby. Took them here for a... Oh! Mama! Oh, doo-doo! I died again. That's what happens when you get sentimental. That's the way the crumbie cookles. Okay. This time, this is like Deathclaw all over again. Just a couple of lanky dudes jacking me repeatedly. Couple of dudes. Here's my game plan, my name of the plan. How do you like a shot in the body? How do you like two bullets wasted? How do you like a piece of hot smoking lead in your chest hole? Okay, so what do we got? Go, dog! Assault! Use your power for good. Ooh. I'm in my gamer pose now. I'm leaning forward. This is the gamer plan of attack formation. How to tell if casual or not. Oh, he's still alive! Do they lean forward when they game? Anybody that games like this, you know something's going on, right? Some kind of amphetamines or something. Alright. Now, this time I'm not going to get cahorbled. What was that? There was a big movement of a shape over there, and I think that it was just like bad glitch type of stuff. Okay. This is the spicy... Oh, yes! Oh, whoa. Oh, no. Oh, no. Where? Don't make me do this! Don't make me do this! Oh, they're every... This one doesn't have a head. Look at this guy, everybody. This guy doesn't like looking around. Oh... Oh, I made a bad mistake. Oh, no, just kidding. It's great. It's a good... Feel the fire. Jeez, Louise. Aid. I am not going to be able to do Corvega assembly plan. Okay, I'm dead again. But the moral of the story is don't lose your cool. Okay, because in that situation, I lost a little bit of my cool. But we know better here. Oh, yeah, I was going to ditch that minigun, huh? Oh, and I was going to use my shotgun, which I didn't. Here's the shot. I have to do that again. Shotgun. Dang it. All right. Save this up. You know what? They say it's a bad idea to go in guns blazing, but after you've died 3 or 4 times, sometimes you just have to throw all caution to the wind. Am I right? You know that strategy, right? Like, use a strategy at first and then just abandon the strategy and just go straight for the nuggets. Oh! Whoa, ooh, that was a big mistake that I just encountered. Oh, that's not the right button. Pushing V for Vats like I'm some kind of dork. Wow. And I call myself a hardcore gamer. I'm just gonna wait a little bit until it's like right in the sweet spot. Okay. There we go. Power of Vats. Oh, this is the intense character over here. Oh, woo, I guess you roll the dice, and you lose sometimes. Forgive me while I encounter some nasal action. That roamer. It's like I'm such a wet piece of paper that I can't handle jack shit right now. Got so much seepage going on in my nasal cavity. All right, so these two. Can get pretty dead early. All right, here's my plan of attack. Oh, thank you, dog. Wait, where'd the other one go? It matches not. Just attack it, dog. Thank you. You bet I can. Whoa. Oh, did it die? Where is it? Oh, it did. Well, I could save scum, but I won't. Because I guess I don't need to call it save scum. If you save, you save. I kind of look at it like the game has encounters. Right? And, like, you want to do, like, the whole encounter in one go. I know that, like, a couple videos down the line, I'm going to just abandon that concept altogether and just save scum the crud out of everything. But in the meantime, I'll pretend to have a moral high ground about it. Okay. This dick. Oh, jeez. Yeah. Oh, you just jump through the flames like a badass. It's the roamer. The roamer gets my goat. God damn it! Wait, did I save? I don't. Did it auto save? I didn't push save. I'm just gonna throw it. I'm just so mad at this stupid roamer. Oh yes, dog. Okay. Last time I trust myself to. That's what I'm talking about. Okay. Get a little bit of. Ooh, if I could just get that. Ooh, flip a coin, heads or tails. I'm just gonna go for the yes, please. Rather than the please and thank you. Okay. Oh, what a just a tackle. Oh, they're behind me. Oh, it's behind me. Oh, that's a bad day. The bad baby. Oh, no bad. Oh, it just sat on my face. Okay. You know, it's getting better, really, and like, oh my god, this is not even like the hard part of the game. What is happening to Rachel? I guess I'll talk about the other great source of Rachel Dratch that I witnessed. Has anyone crouched this whole time? No. I watched season one of Broad City. And I really enjoyed that. And I don't remember her character's name, But she was like a kind of, what do you call it? Oh no. No. Maybe if I shoot you, you'll get out of your animation. She plays like a, oh, what do you call it? Oh, thinking while I'm shooting. She plays a, oh, I don't have any AP. Okay. Oh, I could have hit better there. You know, I deserve to die. I've deserved all these deaths, but that one, that was just unforgivable. What's it called? It's a requisitions expert. It's a commission. Commission. She's like a commissioner or something. She commissions. The cool thing about that role is that the character is completely, like, boring and doesn't matter at all. And you know that she just got it because she's cool. And they were like, oh, Rachel Dratch, will you be in our show? Like, she didn't audition for this part, right? She's just in it because she's a badass. Oh, what a horrible turn of events for me. Just absolutely nothing on that field. Oh my, and then there's, oh, this is just a regular feral ghoul. Okay. Just gonna smack you a couple times. Okay. There's the roamer. The source of all of my negative emotions and feelings in this life. You know what? I gotta stop trying to go for those fancy shots. Oops. Oh my, I got hit out of it. Okay. Oh. I killed it. Now I just have to survive these two cavorting gentlemen. Oh, I gotta heal this leg with a stim pack. You know I got to. How do I do it? Did I click on it? No, I just probably gotta. I think I just use a stim pack and yeah. Oh, there's so many! Oh, I don't have any more of that. You know what? What a bad situation. And to get out of this one, use medics. Just gonna see if that does. It didn't help. I'm not gonna let ghouls get the better of me. Millions of viewers. Rachel Dratch didn't let the ghouls get the better of her when she was still a burgeoning youth on the streets of New York City before her big break. She stood up to those ghouls. Oh. I think it's my angle. It's probably my angle that I gotta work on. There you are. Shoot you once. Shoot you twice. Shoot you three. Dog. Where are you going, dog? Get the ghoul, dog! Get him to the Greek, dog! Never saw that movie. I like to think that, like, I, like, you know, I'm just gonna go ham on it. Just, like, please, God. Oh, my God. No, at least let this third one hit. Wow, okay, you know, three shots to the side of its head. That's okay. I'm done. I'm so done. Where did it even go? Oh, it's getting attacked by my dog now. By the time I get here, it's going to be up again. Oh. Who got that 8-ball? Got that lucky 8-ball and no health. Okay. Gonna use some. Just gonna use the same pack, I guess. No. Some water. Ooh. Water. Water break. I don't care how long it takes. I'm just gonna chill out. I see you over there. Yeah, Broad City, pretty good. Hannibal Buress is in it. I mean, a lot of people are in it, but I was really impressed by Hannibal Buress' performance in Broad City. He has, like, three lines, but they're all amazing. Such good lines. Three great ones. Man. You know how, like, sometimes you can just tell that something's a passion project? Like, they weren't doing this because they're trying to make money. They did this because they were, like, given one shot at doing what they wanted to do. That's kind of how I see Broad City. It's just like these two ladies that are just like given this cool opportunity and they're just going nuts with it.
I recommend it.
But it's not on Netflix, it's on like freaking Hulu and nobody has Hulu. He just appeared from literally behind me and then my dog bit your entire arm off. Okay. So, you know, sometimes you gotta watch stuff just by like Google searching it and then clicking a bunch of links until you find one that doesn't give you a virus, right? Am I right, folks? That's the poor man's Netflix. And the poor man's Netflix would, I guess, be having someone explain the plot to you. Because, you know, like, having the poor anything involve internet is, like, super privileged regardless, so... I feel like I should be able to loot that, because it's glowing red. It's, like, bright red. Now, if I survive this... There's no more music playing. If I survive this, I'm going to be so happy. Oh, that would be amazing. Ooh, look at all these goodies I get. Two cocktails, a mine. Tactical heavy 10mm pistol.
Inventory. Weapons.
Tactical heavy. Oh, so these are 18 damage, right? Tactical heavy, 19 damage. That's plus one damage, alright? That's amazing. I'm gonna put that in my front slot. Yo, look it, it's a green dot. Rachel Dratch picks up this gun, does this, she's like, thought this was just like from the movies only. But now it's for me? Out of this world. Out of this world. In outer space. Yes, it. So now that that has, you know, oh, there's another one. There's two. I just killed them. Oh my gosh. Time to use tactics. Oh my god. This, you know, I don't even care about accuracy at this point. Yeah. I didn't want to do that game. I wanted to reload. Alright. Yeah, you get that one, I'll get this one, dog, okay? Does that sound like a fair deal to you? You get that one, I get this one. Oh, I don't have any more bullets in my shotgun. Great, that'll be really helpful at the Corvega assembly plant. The difficult mission that I'm on my way to. Just strolling down the street, working my way to this difficult mission. Getting my shit pushed in every second. Okay. This time I'm going to use a strategy. Okay, I'm going to squat and I'm going to squeeze. There we go. Drop like a fly to my squat, squeeze, steeze. There you go. Yeah, get a little bit of that type of stuff, type of action in your body. Oh. Yeah. Okay. You know what? Old school time. Oh, Benny's in the ring. Big Benny's taking a hit for the team. Oh, I just... Oh, I gotcha. I gotcha good. Now, this is just two ghouls. You might be thinking to yourself, Caleb / Rachel Dratch, you just took down like a handful of ghouls. Well, what's the matter with two? And the answer is that these are mega ghouls. Just kidding. They're normal. They're regular. Okay. Gonna use this tactical approach here of shooting my last two shotgun bullets into its bloody corpse. Okay, you're dead. You're dead. Don't hit me! Where did you go? Okay, we got some of that. We got a little bit of this. We got a sidewinder effect happening. That's it. Oh, he goes right when I reload. What a dingus. Alright, I'm gonna just shoot a few hyper-accurate shots there. And, what's the button for stim pack? Oh, there's a sleeping one. There's a sleeping one right there that the game shows me. Okay. Yeah, Broad City. Just gonna say that word, those two words again. I was looking at the word broad the other night for research purposes. No, because I was watching Broad City. And, it had that thing where, like, you look at a word and it looks like it shouldn't exist. Like, I was like, broad? Why would you be called broad? That doesn't make any sense. And then city, it's like kitty. If you have a C, why shouldn't you be an S? You know, just typical intelligent things to think about when any other person with a right mind on their head on their shoulders would think about. Am I right? Oh, that guy's so dead. My wooden gun will teach you who's boss. Boo-hoo. Ooh-hoo. Oh, my dog. My dog is jacked. Now, you know what? I'm going to just take this on. There's a sleeping one. But I say to myself, sleep, asleep. I don't need to heal. I'll just shoot you. And I wonder if that was good. Oh, thank goodness. See, I'm getting rich off of these suckers. Right? 7 caps? Now, that's what I'm talking about. I wonder if I'm, like, even close at all. Is this a location? Railroad? Railroad place? Here's a little railroad house. Where the railroad boy lives! Dutchman's instructions. Can I inspect it? That's a blank piece of paper. I'm sorry. This is one interesting Dutchman. Tell you that much. It's one conniving Dutchman to have nothing written down. Okay. Anything? Perhaps another stash of goodies? Take it. Clipboard. Take what you can get. You take what you can get, Steve. Now I'm just going to check this train out. It's getting pretty close to my bedtime, but I can do some gunplay before I fall asleep. Oop! Ooh, speaking of sleep, money. See? Oh, Nuka-Cola. Now, Rachel Dratch is the kind of person to find a silver lining in an apocalyptic scenario. And because of that, she drinks every regular Nuka-Cola that she runs into. Just immediately, just like, bam, slam it down. And I think ask any Rachel Dratch historian / scholar, they'd tell you the same thing. See, now every little lump on the ground looks like a frickin' ghoul that's about to just slap my head. Just give me a slap on the head. That's the plant. That's the Corvega assembly plant.
You gotta be joking.
What? What? Where did that come from? Oh, I'm just trying to get to a hard mission, you dicks. I'm just trying to have a hard time. And here you are getting in my way, making it even harder. Now I have to kill these chumps, because, like, I found them. Right? Like, can't run away. Ooh, can't run away. I'm Rachel Dratch. Can't run away. Yeah, I know where they are. I died. Oh, cows. Oh, my super gun only has 2 bullets. Hey there, you doink. That's another word of the hour, huh? Doink. What was the other one? I don't know. Our fans at home can tell us. There was another word I was saying a bunch earlier. This guy over here, like Dr. Eagle Eye. Dr. Keen Shot McGraw. Alright. Hey there. Yo, hot stuff. Hey, little firecracker. Oh, I gotcha. Knuckles. Knuckles and Long Johns. They sound like the names of characters. Aha. Surely my accuracy will best your accuracy. Okay. Surely. Oh. I'm gonna let go. I'm gonna throw this Molotov cocktail right at this. Oh, where is he? I don't even know where he is. He's right here. Not even close.
Ain't scared yet.
I'm gonna beat you to death. I beat him to death. It worked. I'm gonna take that leg. I'm just gonna take these goggles. I'm just gonna take all this stuff off your body. And now, I'm gonna fast travel back to my little red rocket station. You know, oh, look at how far I made it. I made it all the way here, to my destination here. So just taking a little as the crow flies. You know, like, who says crows have to fly straight? Am I, yeah? This is America. So, gonna do a little bit of gun tinkering. Not what it sounds like. Or maybe, no, it's completely what it sounds like. But first, do I have a perk to put in my gun nut? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Gun nut. Rachel's learned a thing or two about guns and nuts. On this battle-filled mission full of School of Hard Knocks adventure. All right. I always push tab, escape. You know, it's the wrong thing. Push the wrong thing at the wrong time. What can I work on here? Comfort, grip, hair trigger, pipe, pistol. Try saying that 10 times fast. I need to make this automatic. But I can't. All these things require all this, like, junk that I don't have. Tag all this stuff for search. I forgot that I need, like, to save up points and stuff to use on things to make stuff. This tactical, I want to make it automatic. Oh, powerful automatic rank 3 gun nut. I want it. Well, how awkward. Oh, I guess I can do this. Inferior reload speed. I only have 2 frickin' bullets anyway. Sharpshooter. Might as well give this a fancy handle. Look at all this stuff I'm using. I don't care. I'll turn your dog tags into a handle for my hand to grasp my gun. Oh, did I ever mention that, like, by the way, the most ridiculous menu prompt ever is in this game when you push enter to exit. You're literally pushing the button enter to exit. Like, it's a complete opposite of what you're doing. It would be like pushing up to go down. It just baffles my entire mind that they thought that this was a good idea. That they were like, let's make enter exit. Like, it doesn't make any sense. I'm gonna take a nap in both the game and in real life. I'm getting really into character. Hopefully you had fun as I mercilessly was slaughtered multiple times and didn't accomplish anything. I know I did. And Rachel sleeps for 8 hours, okay? Get it in your head. If you enjoyed this, you might enjoy some of the other videos on our channel. You should check them out. In the meantime, time to get some beautiful baby rest. Because I gotta watch season 2 of Broad City and see if Rachel Dratch is in it. And then watch every other sitcom to see if Rachel Dratch is in it. Thank you, and goodbye.